Well, I believe we need to secure our border first and foremost. I believe the borders right now are too open, too porous. They're creating an immigration crisis, a humanitarian crisis at the border. A lot of this is being created by confusing and inconsistent policies coming out of our government. Our president and the positions he's taken to ignore federal law, which says many of these individuals must be not allowed into the country, has said if you can make it here, you know, we're going to give you a chance to stay. And that's brought a lot of people here that wouldn't normally come. So we've incentivized this through federal policy. So I believe on immigration, and particularly on the current crisis facing the southern border, we have to secure the borders. I've been down personally and toured the southern border. It's very porous, very open. People cross back and forth all day long, and there's not much being done to stop it. I think in particular when it's related to El Salvador and Honduras and Guatemala and some of these countries, we are creating, with these inconsistent policies that the president has, he is creating a crisis where these young individuals are coming up through Mexico. Their young women are being raped, people are being sold into sex slavery, and it's because these federal policies have incentivized them to come up.
That's a difficult decision because these are children. You know, when this all comes down to it, these are kids that are leaving communities that are obviously violent, that they don't feel safe in. And when it's all said and done, can you imagine how scared these kids must be to be trying to cross a border, get to the United States, be put in a bus, sent somewhere they've never been? I'm just trying to feel for the kids and what's best for the kids. You know, yes, we probably need to strengthen our borders, but these are children, and I really think it's important that we provide safe haven for these kids and figure out how we can work to keep them from not having to feel that they need to leave their own country and their families. You know, I don't know that that needs to be a federal issue. States have taken that on and made that decision themselves. Some of them are learning that legalized it, are learning from the legislation they passed, whether it was supportive or not. I don't see that issue ever being legal in the state of Kansas. So I don't think it's necessarily an issue in the 3rd District. That's up to the states to decide.
Well, I think the federal law has to be enforced, and the idea that we would ignore certain laws, whether it's ignoring certain immigration laws, which the president's done, ignoring certain health care laws, which the president's done, or ignoring certain drug laws, which the president's doing, I think that just creates a lack of a belief in the rule of law in this country, and it undermines all of our laws. So I think right now we have is a very confusing system and situation. Many of these things ought to really be left to the states to decide, but to the extent we have federal law, it ought to be enforced.